Thank you. just sticking to our first preference, but voting for our second preference, and indeed any preference that we can live with. And that's certainly something I shall be doing. I shall be supporting Labour's unanimously agreed conference policy in favour of a public vote. And I am also minded to support the motion in the name of the Father of the House. But I do, and other members do have concern about this and about the length of the extension, because what I do not want to happen is for the Prime Minister to pocket this as its own political declaration and take us out of the European Union on May 22nd. I don't think that would be acceptable. I have similar concerns about the motion in the name of the honourable member. But it still only has a temporary customs union, and it still could be bagged by the Prime Minister, added to the political declaration, and will be out within a few weeks. I've been waiting for the Honourable Member.
I'm very grateful to the Honourable Member, but I hope he'll recognise that actually the only way in which the government can carry this forward, if there is a cross-party consensus, is to bring in something like the Withdrawal Act Implementation Bill, which gives his party the opportunity to seek to amend it, no doubt with much support around the House, in order to prevent the eventualities he's talking about.
I very much hope that he is right, and I do take his point on that. The other point I wanted to make was absolutely to agree with my right honourable member, the member for Derby. My view is that if we get progress today, if we get a majority on one or more of these